Hello, Andy. My name is Dr. Abhishek Katha. I am a general surgeon in Secunderabad Apollo Hospitals. Today, I will be talking about hernias. Hernia is described as the protrusion of a part or a hole of a viscus from the wall that contains it. That means, whenever there is any wall in the body, if there is any weakness of the wall, and then there will be a small protrusion because of that weakness, and that is described as hernia. And usually these hernias are seen in the abdomen. So the different types of hernias that we can come in across with are inguinal hernias, or it can be femoral hernias, or it can be incisional hernias, and there are other many small types of hernias as well. But the most common ones in males are the inguinal hernias, which come in the inguinal region. And all these hernias, they come with a small swelling either in the groin or in the abdomen or any part of the body. So the first symptom of any of these hernias will be a swelling, and then this swelling will be associated sometimes with pain as well. So this pain is usually described as dragging type of pain, and whenever there is a complication involved in this kind of a hernia, the patient will also have some symptoms of vomitings, constipation, or other GI symptoms as well. So for diagnosing this, initially the patient himself can diagnose himself saying that there's a swelling in the groin or in the abdomen, and then this pain associated with it, and then there will be other GI symptoms. The main diagnosis can be done by the patient itself most of the times, and then if you want a radiological diagnosis or if you want to prove it, then we can always go for an ultrasound abdomen or in the groin, which will tell there is a defect in that particular area, and then we can go accordingly. So these hernias usually will have to go for a surgery because there is no medical treatment for any of these hernias. It is purely a surgical treatment that can help you with. So for the coming to the surgery, we do something called as a hernioplasty, wherein the defected wall, whichever is present, will be closed, and then it will be supported by a synthetic mesh that is called as a proline mesh that we place usually. So it is called as a mesh plasty or a hernioplasty, which supports that particular area where there is a defect in the body. So this is all about hernias. So there are some maneuvers by which you can prevent these hernias, especially by decreasing the intra-abdominal pressure or anywhere in pressure in the body, in fact. So for this, you should not be lifting heavy weights, especially all of a sudden. You're not supposed to lift heavy weights. And then chronic cough, chronic constipation, or chronic any intra-abdominal pressure conditions will lead to hernias. So you should always make sure that there is no increased intra-abdominal pressure by avoiding constipation, and then by avoiding excess straining while passing urine, or by avoiding lifting heavy weights, you can actually avoid hernias also. But then this is all not very sure, because the exaggeration of the hernias will be avoided by these maneuvers, but then we cannot prevent them completely. That's number one. And coming to the post-operative complications, there is always a recurrence chance of these hernias, but usually the recurrence rates are very low. And we have two types of surgeries that we do for these hernias. One is laparoscopy and the other one is open technique. That is the age-old practice what we have been doing. So both these have equal recurrence chances almost, and to avoid the recurrence, even after the surgery, the patients have to avoid lifting heavy weights and to avoid constipation or other intra-abdominal pressures. And if there's anything, you can let me know. Thank you.